Hello and welcome to Method CRM User Tutorials. My name is Errol and today we are going to look at setting up new users. A user is an employee or subcontractor you assign tasks to. You can set up this user to sign into Method so they can check those tasks. Note, this user is different than a QuickBooks user. A Method user and a QuickBooks user are two different things, okay? Before you add a user, you need to make sure you have enough licenses. So first go to the Customize tab and then to My Account. Under My Subscription, we have Apps and User Licenses. Here, you will find Change User Count, and this is where you can increase the number of licenses. We have the price per user here, which may be different for you depending on version. Let me just add one more to the user count. And there we go, the price has increased and I have more licenses. Let's add some users. Stay in the Customize and go over to the Users tab link. Ta-da, here we can create new users. There are two ways to make one. We can invite an existing employee or manually add one. We're going to do both. So let's invite an existing employee. I'll deselect all these ones and I'm going to invite Alex. Click continue. This pops up. For username, I will just set it to the default setting. Next, it asks us which tab groups the user can see and which one they will be in when they first log in. You can change this later, so I'll keep this at default as well. And now I'll click the button to add the user and email the invitation. Ta-da! I'm done! I've added an existing employee. They will get an email, ask them to set up their password, because I can't do that for them. Alex appears down here, and it says that they can sign in, and they are active. And I can edit and delete these users with the links beside each name. Now let's go back and take a look at manually inviting a user. In step one of create new users, I'm going to make sure that's selected. I will enter a username and then I will click continue. Now it will need an email address which will be used for the login. The username is not for logging in, the email will be used. So I will put in an email. The tab groups and initial tab group I will keep at default. And this checkbox enables the new user to log in. All good. I'll click the button to add the user and email him. And it automatically takes me to editing that new user. I'm in step 1 of 10. Here's the login email address. Remember, they use the email to log in. This checkbox allows for mobile login for them if I want them to. This is their username. And down here, I can link them to an employee. I'll link him to Alex since I just added him. Make him do work. All good. Here, the login is active. So let's go on to step 2. This is for email configuration. Step 3 is for notifications and reminders. Step 4 allows you to set up access for specific tab groups. Step 5 are roles and permissions. Step 6 will allow the user to share their records to other users. Step 7 allows for access to the QuickBooks tab group and customize tabs. Step 8 is for access for tables. Step 9 is for customizing screens. And step 10 allows you to set up groups. Cool, let's hit finish. And there we go, we've added a user. We've added two, in fact, in this video. Now, what does a user see? Well, they will get this email, which has a link in it. And when the user goes to that link, they can set up their own password. Huzzah! Once all that's set up and they follow the security rules for their password, they can sign in. And that's it, that's how you add a user. If you have any questions, check out our documentation, post on our forums, or you can tweet us, @MethodCRM. Have a great day. Bye-bye.